Say you do not care for me. Tell me you feel nothing. And I will walk away.
This feeling that plagues us so, it will pass. It will become tenable, it will become bearable. And soon enough it will be as if we never felt it at all. Mere passion. It must, because it has to.
Hope you're wearing your best clothes.
True love is something else entirely. It is when the rest of the world goes quiet. It is not eyes that meet, but souls that dance. Settle into each other. Make room for each other. Until there is nowhere else to hide.
But you must be honest with yourself.
Do you love him?
Because one way or another, these kind of feelings always have a way of coming to the surface.
And what kind of feelings are those?
Once the engagement is over,
love.
Our paths need never cross again. It will be as if we had never met.
Do you think that there is a corner of this earth that you could travel to far away enough to free me from this torment? I am a gentleman. My father raised me to act with honor, but that honor is hanging by a thread that grows more precarious with every moment I spend in your presence. You are the bane of my existence. Object of all my desires. Night and day, I dream of you.
The one that makes it impossible for you to look away from them at any given moment. Body and soul feel as if they could burst into flames whenever the two of you when all you are able to do in their presence is to fight the urge to lean forward and touch their lips.
I thought I could deny my feelings,
but they were too strong.
And I will spend every day of my marriage haunting you.
Are you still planning for me, friend?
Dreaming of you.
She has made her own plans for the future.
But I am leaving for India.
And it is not far enough.
Why are you so distressed?
I am returning to India.
When will you leave?
Plans which do not include me. You are running away.
We have decided there is nothing more between us. There cannot be.
Oh, to be plagued by these feelings.
That scent. We gotta get away from here. It has remained imprinted on my mind ever since the night of the conservatory ball on that day.
I was fearful of losing you.
No. It is why I could not live with you after your accident. It is all my fault. I love you. I have loved you from the moment we raced each other in that path. I have loved you at every dance, on every walk, every time we've been together, and every time we've been apart. You don't have to accept it, you don't have to embrace it, or even allow it, knowing you love it. You must know.
But you don't know this.
You do not have to say
it. I do not think there is anything else to say. So forgive me, if it is now my wish to suspend time, to delay the inevitable, to for a mere moment not think of what comes next.
It is because I've never met anyone like you. It is maddening how much you consume my very being. All I find myself thinking about, all I find myself being able to breathe for, is you. Do you think that I want to be in this position? Contending with these thoughts of wanting to be nowhere except with you. Wanting to run away with you. Fighting my most impure, forbidden desires.
I want a life that suits us both. I know I am imperfect, but I will humble myself before you because I cannot imagine my life without you, and that is why I was doing it.